students, hope you all are fine and enjoying good health at home. And I hope also hope that you have done your previous homework. Now today we are going to start about tenses. What is tense? The tense of the verb tells us time of an action. The tense of a verb tells us the time of an action, means the verb can be changed from one form to another. It can tell about it states a fact or talks about a habitual action. The simple present tense states a fact or talks about a habitual action. The present tense is further divided into four main types: present, simple present, present indefinite, present continuous, present perfect, and present perfect continuous. Now today we are going to discuss about present perfect tense. What it is? It shows that the job has been completed or the work has been done. This tense is used for an action that has just finished. So coming to the sentence structure of the positive sentences. Positive sentences start with capital letter and ends with full stop. The sentence structure is, look at the sentence structure, subject plus helping verb has or have plus third form of verb plus object. In this sense, present perfect tense means the work has done, so we use the helping verb has or have. Look at the conditions, that has is used with singular subject, that is he, she, it, and have is used with plural subject or the first noun, that is I, we, you, they. We, you, they are plural subject, so we use have with it. Third form of verb is used. As compared to the previous two tenses, simple present tense and present continuous tense, in which first form of verb is used, in this tense we use third form of verb plus object. Urdu fikre ke aakhir mein diya hai, that he has done, chuka hai, chuke hain, chuki hoon, aata hai. Look at the examples given to you of the positive sentences. Isne sabak yaad kar liya hai. She has learned the lesson. As you can see that she is the singular subject, that's why we use has for it. And third form of verb learn, the third form jo hai, that is learned. She has learned the lesson. Wo nazam padha chuke hain. That is the plural. Wo se hume pata chal raha hai that this is the plural sentence. They have taught the poem. Main nashta kar chuka hoon. It means that is about the first person. So we also use have with it. I have taken breakfast. So coming to the next part is that is all about the positive sentences. These are the few examples given to you to understand. In present, I'm repeating, in present perfect tense, has or have is used before the third form of verb. If the subject in the sentence is he, she, it or singular noun, then we use helping verb has with them. And if the subject in the sentence is I, we, you, they or plural noun, then we use helping verb has with them. For example, I will tell you a few more examples, that I have taken tea, we have taken examination, father has arrived in, the peon has rung the bell. These all are the example of the positive sentences of the present perfect tense. So coming to the negative sentences of the present perfect tense, look at the sentence structure, that is in negative sentences, not is added before the third form of verb and after auxiliary verb. You can see that subject plus has not or have not according to the subject. If it is singular subject, then we use has not, and then if it is plural subject, then we use have not plus third form of verb plus object. Look at the examples given to you. Hum chai pee nahi chuke hain. We have not taken tea. Chuke hain. Matlab that they had not taken tea. We have not taken tea. Suraj nahi doob chuka hai. The sun has not set in. Father has not arrived. We have not played cricket. You can see that before verb there is not, and after auxiliary verb, helping verb, we use not. That is all about the negative sentences. So coming to the interrogative sentences, with the sentence structure of interrogative sentences, the Subject is followed, has, we use has or have at the start or beginning of the sentence plus subject and third form of verb plus object in question mark. Interrogative sentences are question sentences that ends with question mark. Has or have sometimes is followed by the question words that are who, when, what, which. These are the question words. So look at the examples given to you. Kya tum kaam khatam kar chuke ho? Have you finished your work? And use question mark at the end of the sentence. Have you finished your work? You can see that this is about the second person and use have with it. Then kya shikari parinde pakad chuka hai? Has the hunter caught the bird? Have, hunter is the singular subject, that's why we use has with it. And kya ye ladka imtihan pass kar chuka hai? Has this boy passed the examination? You can see that in all those positive, negative and interrogative sentences, the form of verb remains the same, that is third form of verb. And we use helping verb has or have with them. That is all about the interrogative sentences. What you have to do is to choose the verb of your own choices. Then we will provide you with the exercise so that you can do practice at home of the present perfect tense, and you have to translate that, those sentences in on your notebook. So this is our homework time. You have to do practice of present perfect tense. You have to choose the verb of your own choice, and then you can use in the sentences of your own by following the sentence structure of positive, negative and interrogative sentences. Translate the sentences given to you in the homework for practicing. You have to learn the composition verb of first term, that is the story, letter or application, story, letter and application, that includes the first that is in your first term. Stay home, stay safe. Thank you very much of your homework. Thank you very much. Stay home, stay safe. Allah Hafiz. Take care.